Today I fucked up when I got kidnapped by a girl, nearly shot by her Confederate stepfather, and hitchhiked to the wrong city. This is a long one, and I hope this counts. If not, feel free to remove. P.S. ET equals estimated time. 3 years ago, I went on a vacation to Los Angeles, California with two friends. We went out one night, to some club, and in walked an absolutely stunning woman. Latina girl, looked to be about 22 or 23, done up to the nines. Anyway, I went to buy two drinks and by the time the drinks were made, she disappeared into thin air. On /ET, 12 a.m., we were all tired, because we had been up for nearly 24 hours, so we went home to sleep. I get on Tinder, not making much of it, and start swiping for fun. All of a sudden, I get a super like, notified that someone really liked my profile. I shit you the fuck not. It was her. After confirming I was at the same club as her that night, she said she wanted to come say hi, but her friends dragged her out. She asks me if I wanted to hang out, and I say sure, but that I'm not from the area. She picks me up in her BMW M5 2017, this was in 2017, and we head to the mountains. /ET, 3 a.m. We're just chilling and I'm visibly exhausted, so I don't even try to make a move, and I'm like yeah I should probably head home. She says, why not come over to my place? Me being the horny fuck I am, I say okay. On the way to her house, I fell asleep. For 2 hours. I woke up and thought, wait? We're still driving? I asked where she lived and she said San Francisco. She was driving me 8 hours away from my friends. Again, being the horny fuck I am, I go back to sleep. /ET, 11 a.m., I wake up to the smell of fire and see smoke coming out of the side of the car. Her run flat tire exploded and was just smoking. Pulled over on the highway, had sex in her back seat, and then called a tow. Turns out her credit card had recently been stolen and she was waiting for the new one. She tells AAA to cancel the truck and Googles the nearest tire shop. Coincidentally, it's 2 miles up the road. I walk my ass down the road, buy a tire, with her money of course, walk back, and change her tire. /ET, 1 p.m., we finally get to her house. We're on her driveway, and she says, oh, I forgot to tell you. Long story short, I was adopted. My adopted parents got a divorce, and my adopted mother ended up marrying this super racist guy. He's a Confederate and he owns guns. You need to sneak into my bedroom without him seeing, because he will shoot. I thought she was fucking lying to me. Walk into the house and see 4 large Confederate flags, and a wall of vintage guns. There was also a pistol on the dinner table and her step-tilde psycho tilde father was walking around on the phone, smoking a cigarette. I book it into her room, finally I felt safe. /ET, 2 p.m., she talks to her stepdad and tells him that she has to study, so he shouldn't bug her. We're now smashing, again, and her stepdad knocks on the door. He tells her that he is going to the grocery store. We move into the living room, where we start smashing for a third time. I see his Confederate flag, and I know she hates him at this point, so I pull the flag down and we're having sex on his flag. My plan was to nut on his flag and hang it back up. Sorry r/users, don't get butt hurt, I was a kid. All of a sudden, I hear a back door open. This motherfucker came home early, and he sees me clear as daylight. He charges to his car, I charge to her room, and she charges after her stepdad to slow him down. She runs upstairs to me and gives me $300 and tells me to catch a cab back. Get dressed as quickly as possible, and he picks up the flag, picks up a revolver, and comes to her room. He's banging on the door, as I'm getting my clothes on and before I get my shoes on, and he is screaming. I open her bedroom window, climb onto her roof, and the moment he breaks the door down, I jump into her pool. I quickly looked up and saw him see me in the pool. He shouted down that he was going to come down and shoot me. I hopped her fence, and that was the last time I ever saw that crazy fucking lady again. /ET, 4 p.m., I have the $300 she gave me, but keep in mind, I just jumped into a pool. My cell phone is dead, and likely damaged, and I'm looking for a cab. I'm fucking soaking wet. The money is soaking wet. Oh, also, I don't even know the fucking address of the place my friends are staying, and by this point, they've definitely called the police trying to find me. I stick my thumb out on the highway, and a van pulls over with some frat guys in it. I tell them what happened, and they say, "Dude, sleep in the back and we're literally headed that way right now. We'll take you right to your friends." /ET, 1 AM, I wake up. The van stopped. Where the hell am I? Why the hell did I get into another car with a stranger for 8+ hours? I look out of the window of the trunk, and my heart drops. I told them I needed to get to LA, but I see a sign that says San Diego, California. To make matters worse, they had a phone charger in the car and I completely forgot to charge my phone. /ET, 2 AM, I walk into the San Diego International Airport and check flights to Los Angeles. There was one. Price? $295. /ET, 6 AM, I flew back to LA, had $5, my passport, a dead cell phone battery, and the worst smelling clothes you could image. /ET, 8 AM, I end up finding the McDonald's near the town we were in, asking people for a cell phone, getting one, going onto Facebook, and messaging my friends. They send me the address and I walk the 5 miles. /ET, 10 AM, I knock on the door, they open it, and I tell them to get ready. I've got a story that you're not going to fucking believe. Edit, too long didn't read, fell asleep in girl's car going back to her house 8 hours away. Nearly shot by her stepdad when he found us sleeping together. Jumped off her roof into her pool. No cell phone. Caught a hitchhike to San Diego with frat guys instead of LA. Caught a flight to LA with $300 she gave me. DMHS. The post title sounds like r/subreddit simulator. First account post, cut me some slack lol. Noobing. Is no one going to question him walking 2 miles to buy a tire? I assume you didn't have the machine to swap just the tire on the rim on the side of the road. Yeah, everyone else is finding very random details to pick apart, when to me, the whole I went to the tire store 2 miles down the road and then came back and just popped it on reeks of BS. Gonna be honest, despite how many times you say it's real and how much I want to believe it, it's just so hard to convince myself that it's real and I'm too tired to pick it apart to find an error in it right now. I stopped reading after the flaming flat tire sex. The title reeked of shitpost, but I regretfully gave up the benefit of a doubt. I don't believe this story. Why would she drove you for 8 hours if all she wanted to do was have a one-night stand? Why was she in that place 8 hours away from home? Is she studying there? She would probably have a place there to sleep and live right around there. Also, you apparently have infinite potence, but what is most unlikely is getting a super like from a hot girl on Tinder. Has any guy ever experienced that? You must be a 9 or 10. This is very well written story, but unfortunately there are too many loopholes, so I call BS. Well, one suspicious bit in this story is the changed tire. Because you either change the whole wheel, which means he bought a wheel with a matching rim for that exact car on a weekend somewhere between LA and SF and rolled it back to the car, or he took the rim of the car, and somehow managed to carry that 2 miles to the tire store and have them change the tire, then roll it back. Anybody who ever changed a wheel on a car, let alone a probably 17 rim on a decent Beamer, will know that both options are pretty crazy. These things are heavy. I don't buy that part of the story. Today I fucked up by calling my wife mom during sex. So me and my wife have been together for over 10 years. Last night I was taking her to Pound Town as usual and my wife knows that I hate being called daddy, I find it weird as we have daughters. Sometimes she says it to bug me. Well, I'm hitting it from the back pretty good and she calls me daddy. I stop, I tell her to STFU. We laugh. Then I start to get back my rhyme and I called her mom as seriously as I can. How do you like that, mom? She pauses for a second and responds, "Yeah, fuck me, good son." Then I started saying stuff like, "I have always wanted to stuff you full, mom." She says, "Yeah, you have been naughty, skipping school, etc., etc." Anyways, after cum, I feel disgusted with myself, but my wife seemed fine. So things go on, and today it's about the time to get frisky, and my wife comes up to me and tells me she wants to pretend to be my mother again and role play that I have a girlfriend and she's an overbearing mother who wants to show her son how he is supposed to be treated. Well, my post-nut regret from last time was gone, so I got super horny and we did it. I didn't even feel disgusting afterwards. My wife loved it. The weird thing is, she made me call her by my real mom's name. Too long didn't read, started a weird fantasy of my wife's, I think, and I'm not sure how I feel about it. Plot twist, your mom makes your dad pretend to be you when they fuck. You need to move on from this ASAP. Buy a strap-on and get into pegging. You get to call her daddy. I think he'd have to call her Peggy. You think she's been watching incest porn? I'm scared to ask now. Okay, I was cool and on board the way up until she made you use your real mom's name. The fact. Inspected Op's history. Op is both a fraud and a sexual deviant. Yeah, dude. He's fucking weird. Literally 95% of his posts look like they were written by a horny 13-year-old. Today I fucked up by telling my 3-year-old he has a bum crack. I'll start by stating, I am very much British. Therefore, this story will use the term bum a lot, and not butt. So last night before bed, my toddler picks his bedtime story. Same one as a few nights ago. It's called I Need a New Bum, by Dawn McMillan. It's about a lad who realizes he has a bum crack and goes on a quest to shops and magical places to replace his bum in weird and wonderful ways, until the end, he sees his dad bent over repairing the kitchen sink, and sees he has a bum crack too, think builder's bum, and he realizes it's okay. So I mistakenly told my 3-year-old, hey, guess what? You have a bum crack too. Isolation is getting to him. Cue him bawling his eyes out. Absolutely inconsolable, and wouldn't settle to sleep. He asked me if he could go to the shop to buy a new one. I tried to explain that it was normal and you couldn't buy bums. He was convinced this new crack was hurting him, whilst I tried to convince him otherwise. I even had to kiss it better. That didn't help. Like the end of the story, I'm not ashamed to say I tried to show him mine. That didn't help. His dad took over and explained the physical reasons we need a bum crack. Poop, to walk, to move. It took a lot of convincing and persuasion to settle him, whilst he cried and cried. And today he keeps reminding me of all the reasons why it is important to have a bum crack, including examples of how he would walk. But I think he's getting over it. TL Doctor, I told my 3-year-old he has a bum crack, which resulted in me breaking his heart. If anyone wants to hear the story, thank you /u/CHH10N402_addict_. Ha! He got you to kiss his ass. What has my life become? Till Brits use the term builder's bum while Americans say plumber's crack. In Germany we say mason's cleavage. When my daughter was 3, she started in hysterics while in the bath, and when I asked what was wrong, she told me her bum was broken because it had a hole in it. This is one of my son's 4 favorite books, to the point where he likes to see if people's bums are cracked and if they need a new bum. Hopefully we'll get to that stage when he's recovered from the trauma.